गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कोलाइड्स। एज अर्लियर वी हैव ऑल्सो स्टडीड अबाउट दिस टॉपिक, बट दैट क्लासिफिकेशन वॉज बेस्ड ऑन द फिजिकल स्टेट ऑफ डिस्पर्स्ड फेज एंड डिस्पर्शन मीडियम। फ्रॉम देयर वी गेट द सॉलिड सॉल्स, द एरोसॉल्स, द इमल्शंस। सो दैट वॉज द वेरी फर्स्ट क्लासिफिकेशन of collides that is based on physical state of dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Now we will discuss about the very second classification, that is based on nature of interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. Okay students, you earlier know about what is dispersed phase and what is dispersion medium. Dispersed phase, I have said you, that's just think an example of a smoke. For this, you know, the dispersed phase will be solid, that is the dust particles, and the dispersion medium will be gas, that is air. Okay, so air is, that is gas, and solid particle, that is dust particle. So what are dispersed phase? They are just substance distributed as the colloidal particle. Okay, and what is dispersion medium? This is the phase in which the colloidal particles are scattered. Okay, so now students, let's start to our today's topic, that is the classification which is based on nature of interaction between dispersed phase and dispersion medium. How both the mediums or phases are just interacted, their nature. So for this, the collides are classified as lyophilic collides and lyophobic collides. Okay, here you can see the very first, that is lyophilic collide, and the very second, that is lyophobic collide. So for these two, we will understood these two differences between them. So let's differentiate them. You can also understood them as reversible salts or irreversible salts. So let's start. You can see the very first difference, that is these are solvent loving collide. From the word philic, it indicates that it is solvent loving. But in case of lyophobic, phobic, you know about phobia, dar. So they are solvent that are hating collides. Okay, that is solvent hating collides. Now let's come to the very second point, that is how they form. So for this, the lyophilic collides are directly formed by mixing substances like gum, gelatin, starch, etc. So they are simply prepared by directly mixing the substances like germ, gelatin, etc. Okay, but what about lyophobic? They cannot be formed directly. Okay, there are some special methods for their formation. Now let's talk about the very third point, that is the lyophilic collides are quite stable, but in case of lyophobic, what you see, these are not stable salts. Okay, these are not stable. Now let's come to the fourth point, that is their example. So for example, you can see in case of lyophilic collides, there is example of salts of starch, and in case of lyophobic collide, there is the example of salts of gold, etc. Now students, as earlier also discussed, the lyophilic collides are also called reversible. Okay, but the lyophobic collides are called irreversible. So this is about the differences, that is lyophilic and lyophobic, and on what basis they are differentiated. They are differentiated on the basis of their preparation, their nature, their reversibility, is they are reversible or not, and what is the major classification of them. The major classification is just based on their nature of interaction. Okay, now students, let's come to the third classification. Okay, the third classification is on the basis of type of particle of dispersed phase. Here we have to only look over the dispersed phase and about the type of particle it is. Type, or you can understood simply it as the size of particle, whether the particles are molecule or a smaller molecule, that may be larger molecule, or whether the particles are ion. On the basis of these, they are categorized into three, that is multimolecular collides, macromolecular collides, and associated collide. So let's talk about all the three. The first one is multimolecular chloride. What happens here in this type of collide, द कोलाइडल पार्टिकल आर एग्रीगेट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल. ओके, वॉट दे आर सिंपली द एग्रीगेट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल एंड दे आर स्मॉलर इन साइज. सपोज यू कैन सी द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सल्फर, यू कैन सी द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ गोल्ड. ही आर द पार्टिकल्स आर जस्ट एग्रीगेटेड, वेरी स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स आर एग्रीगेटेड. देयर मॉलिक्यूलर मास आर नॉट वेरी हाई, दे आर अप टू द रेंज. बट नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द सेकेंड. वैन यू विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सेकेंड देन यू विल क्लियरली अंडरस्टूड दिस. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द सेकेंड, दैट इज मैक्रोमोलिकुलर क्लोराइड्स. वॉट हैपन्स हियर, दे आर मेड अप ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ सफिशियंटली लार्ज साइज. वॉट वी आर सीइंग, दे आर जस्ट फॉर्म बाई द एग्रीगेशन ऑफ लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल. ओके, लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल दैट मे बी स्टार्च, सेलुलोज, प्रोटीन. सो दे आर, यू ऑल नो दैट दे आर जस्ट मैक्रोमोलिक्यूल्स. दे आर वेरी लार्ज इन साइज. सो फॉर दिस देयर मॉलिक्यूलर मासेज आर ऑल्सो वेरी हाई. Why? Because long chain, due to long chain, the van der Waals forces holding them are comparatively strong. So this is about the macromolecule. Let's recall back the multi-molecule, molecular collide. So for multi-molecular collide, they are also aggregate of molecule, but their sizes are small. But in case of macromolecule, they are aggregate of large molecules that may be starch, cellulose or protein. Now let's talk about the very third, that is associated collide. What they are? So they are formed by aggregation of large number of ions. Here the size is large, but what happens here, the gathering or the aggregation is of ions, or you can say electrolyte. Okay, earlier the collides formed, that is multi or macro, are formed by the aggregation of molecule, but here associated collide are aggregation of ions or electrolyte. For example, soaps, detergents. Okay, so students, they are formed above a particular concentration. So for this, for associated collide, you have to remember two terms, that is CMC. This is called as critical micelle concentration, and you have to know KT, that is Kraft temperature. So what happens for associated collide, they can be formed above a particular concentration. This concentration is called CMC, that is critical micelle concentration. If they will reach this concentration, then only the associated collides are formed, and also they require a particular temperature, that is called as Kraft temperature. So they must achieve this Kraft temperature so that the associated collide may be formed. So students, this is all about our today's lecture. That is, we have discussed today about the classification of collide, that is based on nature of interaction of dispersed phase and dispersion medium. They are classified as lyophilic, which are solvent loving, and lyophobic, which are solvent hating. Okay, now we have also studied another classification, that is based on type of particle, or you can say that size of particle. So they are classified as multimolecular, where small particles are aggregated, small molecules are aggregated. Example, S8, gold. They can be classified as macromolecular collides, where large molecules are aggregated like starch, protein, and they may be associated collides, where large ions or electrolytes are aggregated, and for this they must require a CMC, that is critical micelle temperature, and KT, that is a Kraft temperature. So students, this is all about our today's lecture. Thank you, class.